also for South Africa, since we mentioned 2015 and Grant Elliott and all that, it's actually, we feel, had a more deep effect on South African cricket in general, because it was after that that we started asking questions, will AB de Villiers be around for the next World Cup? By 2018, the answers in the negative. Also, there were issues with Vernon Philander playing that game in place of Kyle Abbott, who then went on to become a Kolpak player. So just two examples from there that game actually hurt South Africa more than we could have imagined.
I think players have been opting out being Kolpak players for years now. You know, so that is not something which is new, which South African cricket has been dealing with. I think what has happened in the recent past is also to do something which what's happening in EU. You know, so the Kolpak players, England may not be part of EU, and that restricts players from being Kolpak players. You know, and that's the rule. So that is something which has triggered this movement of a lot of players opting for it, because they don't know whether they will have that option in a few years to come. So because there is no clarity, sudden migration of players has happened, and that has an impact on South African cricket in a negative way as we speak. But just that incidence of 2015 is not something which I think is affecting South African cricket. It's just a general way of a team going through transition as well. You know, you have to look at future and how they are tackling with the issues which are surrounding these kind of questions. But on the whole, you've seen some great talent coming out as well. What South Africa needs, I feel, is someone to really put things together and really get the maximum out of each player, you know, and make them play as a team and help them, most importantly, deal with these kind of scenarios and situations which has sort of formed a pattern. You know, that pattern is something which they have to break away, and someone needs to really analyze it and get things together, because potential is there, talent is there. I don't see this 15 is not capable of winning matches. Yes, they are capable of winning matches. It's just they have to figure out a few things.
See, for me, South Africa has always been a side where the parts have been larger than the whole. You put the 11, all 11 together, they've always looked a very impressive 11. They've just not performed to that. You know, many teams are the reverse. New Zealand is exactly the reverse. Mane talent itna hai, but they'll perform this much. South Africa seems to have this much talent and doesn't seem to always. And that's why you see, what is the one memory they always go back to? They go back to that game of 434, 438. Because that was one day that they played above their level. Otherwise, mostly you'll see South Africa failing to do what their potential or talent does. And I think more of it has to do with here, more of it has to do with maybe the coach, the captain, the system. Because one of the great things about South African cricket is they have both, tap of both the gharanas. You have the, you know, young fast bowlers like Ngidi, Rabada coming out. There's this whole lots of them coming out. And you have the typical Pretoria precocious cricketers, you know, the Fab Du Plessis and the, you know, Jacques Callises, they also have that. They have both those gharanas of cricket with them. So if they can combine it, they're a sensational side. But that combination is what they're not getting right now.